Professor Dave again, let's continue with differentiation.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We just introduced the concept of differentiation by looking at tangent lines, so its definition may be starting to crystallize in your mind. But let's examine this concept in one more context, just to be thorough. When we introduced calculus, we talked about how Newton pondered a falling body, perhaps like his mythical apple. He knew that if an object was dropped some short distance from rest, meaning with an initial velocity of zero, that velocity would necessarily increase in the negative direction every single instant until hitting the ground. He then wondered how one could calculate the velocity of the apple at any particular instant during the fall. This is called the instantaneous velocity. Galileo had already discovered some years prior that the distance traveled by a falling object, represented by s of t, would be equal to 4.9 t squared, with t in seconds, giving a distance in meters. So Newton could easily use this law to calculate how far something would fall over a given interval of time. But this was not the problem at hand. Newton wanted to know something not about an interval of time, but rather about an instant in time, like perhaps the velocity of the apple precisely 5 seconds after letting it fall. Well, just like we did in the previous tutorial with the secant and tangent lines, let's make an approximation. We can calculate average velocity by taking some distance traveled and dividing by the time elapsed, as that will be meters traveled over seconds traveling, or meters per second. And using Galileo's equation, we can express distance traveled as the difference between two points in this function. Say we use the distance traveled after 5 seconds, or s of 5, and the distance traveled after 6 seconds, or s of 6. If we subtract the former from the latter, we are necessarily describing the distance traveled during the period from 5 to 6 seconds after being dropped. That will also mean that the time elapsed is 1 second. So we just evaluate the functions for these two inputs and subtract. Divide by 1 second, and we get 53.9 meters per second. So that is the average speed of the apple during that 1 second interval. But remember, we don't want an average speed. We want the precise speed at a precise instant. So what do we do? Well, just like the way we nudged the second point in the line closer to the first until we got the tangent line for the curve, let's nudge the end of this time interval closer and closer to 5 seconds. We can use 5 and 5.1 to get the average velocity over this tenth of a second, and we get 49.49 meters per second. Then we can use 5 and 5.01 to get the average velocity over this hundredth of a second, and continue to get even narrower from there. If we were to continue in this manner, we would see the average velocity get closer and closer to 49. So the instantaneous velocity of the apple precisely 5 seconds after being dropped must be 49 meters per second. This approach feels pretty similar to what we were doing with the tangent line. In fact, it's not just similar, it's exactly the same. In both cases, we are performing differentiation. If we draw the graph of 4.9 t squared, all we were doing in shortening that time interval was nudging the second point in this line closer and closer to the first point, sitting at 5 seconds, so that we can get that tangent line. And it is the slope of the tangent line that gave us our instantaneous velocity. This is equivalent to saying that the rate of change on the distance curve is distance over time, or velocity. This fact is no coincidence, and we will come back to this concept later. For now, let's continue examining introductory calculus concepts. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.